Niti namine, namaste Sarasati Devi, Gauravani Precharine, Nirvisesha Shunyavadi, Paschacya Desatarine, Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha, Patitanam Pavan Ebyo, Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're going through the Srimad Bhagavatam. This is 6th canto, chapter 5, how Daksha curses Narada Muni.
我们学习的是圣典博伽瓦坛第六篇的第五章, 了解到的是 Daksha 他是如何诅咒 Narada Muni的。
So Narada Muni had preached to the two groups of sons of Daksha. First of all, 10,000 sons, and then 1,000 sons, and he convinced them not to go home.
Narada Muni 给Daksha的两批儿子们传教, 第一批是10,000个儿子,第二批是1,000个儿子, Narada Muni 说服了他们不要回家了。After
hearing from Narada Muni, they took the renounced order of life. They never went home again.
当他们接受了Narada Muni的建议之后,他们 也进入到气绝阶层,再也没有回到家里面。
When Daksha heard the news that his sons were not coming home, he was very angry, and he spoke to Narada Muni, expressing his anger.
当Daksha听到他的儿子不再回家的这个消息之后,他非常生气,于是向Narada Muni宣泄了他的愤怒。
Narada Muni was hoping that he could convince Daksha also to renounce the world and take to devotional life.
Narada Muni 也在等待着Daksha能够同样的进入到气绝阶层回归受身。
However, Daksha was not inclined that way. Instead, Daksha is explaining his philosophy of life to Narada Muni.
但是Daksha并没有接受Narada Muni的建议和他反而行之的是他给Narada Muni讲述了他自己的那一套哲学。Daksha
is explaining to Narada Muni that he is a householder and he lives with his wife and children.
Daksha给Narada Muni说他是一个居士,他得和他的妻子和孩子们生活在一起。
Daksha told Narada Muni that he honestly follows the Vedic injunctions.
Daksha跟Narada Muni说,我也在遵循这些伟大的训示。
He also said that he performs fruitive activities to enjoy life without sinful reactions.
Daksha说,我在遵循这些果报活动的方式,然后享受生活,但是并不过这种罪恶的生活。
Daksha said he had performed all kinds of yagyas.
Daksha说,我做了所有的伟大的祭祀.
He had performed a yagya for the pleasure of the demigods.
他为半神人供奉祭祀.
And he performed a yagya for the pleasure of the rishis, the great sages.
他为这些圣人们做祭祀.
And he performed a yagya for the pleasure of the forefathers. And he did one also for the humans. So Daksha is explaining to Narada Muni, he said, because I performed all these yagyas, He is known as a Grihavrat.
因为我做了这些祭祀，所以我应该被称为 Grihavrata。
Vrata means a vow.
Vrata 的意思是誓言。
So these yagyas, they're also called vows.
所有的这些祭祀也被称为誓言。
So that's how Daksha got the name Grihavrata.
所以这就是 Daksha 应该得到一个 Grihavrata 的名字。
Grihavrata means that one vows to stay at home.
Grihavrata 的意思是一个誓言留在一个发誓留在家里面的人。
Then Daksha said to Narada Muni that you've upset me a lot by misguiding my sons. You misguided my sons. It really upset me.
Daksha 说你把我的儿子们误入了歧途。叫我非常的生气。
You got my sons to take to the path of renunciation.
你误导我的儿子们走向弃绝之途。
Daksha said, I can tolerate this one time, but you did it twice.
Daksha 说，我一般只能容忍这样的事情发生一次，但是呢，你向我做了两次这样的事情。
Daksha wanted to show Narada Muni that he'd been very tolerant in dealing with him.
Daksha 想要跟 Narada Muni 想要向他证明我本来应该是一个很容忍的人。
In the beginning, Narada Muni took away his 10,000 sons to renounce the world.
在最开始的时候 ，Narada Muni 把 Daksha 的一万个儿子带到了弃绝之途。
Householders are often called Grihamedis because they're very satisfied with family life and they have no spiritual desires to advance, no desire to advance in spiritual life. So they're called Grihamedis.
有一些居士被咒骂为 Grihamedi， 因为这样的一些居士，他们只满足于家庭生活，并不追求灵性的进步。
A Grihasta is one who has, although he's in family life, he has his desire to advance in spiritual life.
而一个被称为 Grihasta 的居士，他意味着希望能够在灵性的生活上获取进步。
Even though he has a wife and he has children, but still he wants to make spiritual advancement.
即便他和他的孩子、妻子们在一起过着家居的生活，但是他非常渴望灵性的进步。
Daksha was telling Narada Muni that when you took my first 10,000 sons away, I didn't get angry with you.
Daksha 跟 Narada Muni 说，在你把我的第一批一万个儿子带走了之后，我当时并没有对你很生气。
I was kind and I tolerated.
我当时非常的仁慈，而且表现出了容忍。
But now you've done it a second time.
但是现在你第二次做了同样的事情。
In this way, Daksha is telling Narada Muni that.Although you're dressed like a holy man, you're not actually a holy man.
Daksha 还想向 Narada Muni 说，虽然你穿得像一个圣人，但是实际上你并不是一个圣人。
And Daksha said, actually, although I'm a householder, I'm a better holy man. I'm more of a holy man than you are, Narada Muni.
然而。我虽然穿的是一个居士，但是我却比你这样的圣人要更圣人一些。
Then Daksha tells Narada Muni that you made me lose my sons once, and now you have done it again, the same thing.
Daksha 说，你已经使我失去了一次儿子们，现在你又做了同样的事情。
It's a very inauspicious thing which you've done.
你做的这件事情对我来说非常的不吉祥。
So you are a rascal. Daksha says to Narada Muni, you're a rascal. You don't know how to behave towards others.
Daksha 跟 Narada Muni 说，你简直就是一个恶棍，你根本就不知道如何恰当的和别人进行交往。
So Daksha says to Narada Muni, you can travel all over the universe.
Daksha 说，你可以在整个宇宙去旅行。
But I curse you to have no residence anywhere.
但是我诅咒你，你在宇宙之中没有任何一个自己的居所。
So because Prajapati Daksha, he was a Grihamedi, so he wanted to remain in family life.
因为 Prajapati Daksha, 他是一个 Grihamedi, 所以他一直想要过，他想一直过这种居士的生活。
Daksha thought that if Narada Muni could not remain in one place, but if he has to travel, that would be a punishment for him.
从 Daksha 的角度来看，如果 Narada Muni 一直在宇宙的宇宙不停的旅行，没有一个固定的居所来说，如果没有一个固定的居所的话，这对 Narada Muni 来说就是一种惩罚。
But actually for Narada Muni, a punishment like that is a blessing, because Narada Muni is a preacher.
但是从 Narada Muni 的角度来看，如果我能够一直这样旅行，而没有一个固定居所，这对于我来说就是一种祝福。
And a preacher is, they're called, the title of somebody who's preaching and traveling, they're called Paribrajakacharya.
一位传播的这个导师，他被称为 Paribrajakacharya。
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 So it means he's an acharya or he's a teacher who always travels for the benefit of others.
被称为这样的一个导师，他总是为着人类的利益而云游四方。
Prajapati Daksha cursed Narada Muni, saying that he has to travel all over the universe.
Prajapati Daksha 诅咒 Narada Muni, 你得在整个宇宙不停的旅行。
I would never be able to stay in one place.
你永远不可能在一个地方逗留。
So then Srila Prabhupada says, he said, I am in the parampara system, we are in the disciplic succession coming from Narada Muni.
圣帕帕德在这里说，我们也是来自 Narada Muni 的这个师徒传系。
And Prabhupada said, I have also been cursed the same way.
圣帕帕德说，我也以同样的方式受到了诅咒。
Although I have, Prabhupada said, I have many centers that would be good places for me to stay.
圣帕帕德说，虽然我有很多的中心都可以作为我很好的居所。
But Prabhupada said, I cannot stay anywhere.
但是帕帕德说，我不可能在任何一个地方逗留。
Prabhupada said, I have been cursed by the parents of my young disciples.
因为我受到我年轻的门徒的这些父母们的诅咒。
Prabhupada explains, he said, when I started the Krishna consciousness movement, I traveled around the world.
圣帕帕德在这里解释到，自从我开始这个 Krishna 知觉运动开始，我每一年都在全世界旅行。
And I go around the world two or three times a year.
每一年都周游世界两到三次。
And everywhere I go, they give me very nice accommodation.
我去到的任何一个地方，他们都给我非常好的住处。
But I cannot stay anywhere for more than 3 days or a week.
但是我却不能在一个地方停留到三到一个星期这么长时间，我无法停留这么长时间。
But Prabhupada said, I don't mind this curse.
但是帕帕并不在意这个诅咒。
He said, this is the parents of my disciples. They have cursed me like this.
这是我门徒的父母们他们的诅咒。
But Prabhupada said, now it's necessary for me to stay in one place.
圣帕巴达说，但是现在我必须得停留在一个地方。
He said, I have to finish another task. There's something I want to do. I want to finish the translation of Srimad Bhagavatam.
我现在得停留在一个地方去翻译圣典博迦瓦坛。
Prabhupada explains that he wants the young devotees, especially those who have taken sannyas, to go and travel all over the world.
圣帕帕德希望他的这些年轻的门徒们，尤其是那些接受了萨利亚西启迪的这些门徒们，能够负责代表他去周游世界。
Prabhupada said, if they will travel, then I don't need to travel.
如果他们能够去旅行的话，我就不必去旅行了。
Prabhupada said, I can give the curse which these parents of my young disciples gave me, I can give the curse to my sannyasi disciples.
这些年轻门徒的父母给我的诅咒，我可以把这个诅咒就给予我的这些年轻的门徒们，让他们去接受这个诅咒。
And Prabhupada said, then in this way, I can sit down quietly and in one place and do the work of translation.
这样我就可以获得方便，在一个地方待着，好好的翻译。
So this was when Prabhupada was writing the sixth canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
这是圣帕帕德在翻译圣典博迦瓦坛第六篇的时候所写下的。
Must have been about 1974, maybe.
大概是在1974年左右。
Anyway, Prabhupada never got to really sit down.
但是不管怎么样，圣帕帕德始终没有踏踏实实的坐下来过。
So then Sukadeva Goswami is speaking. He's telling this story.
然后 Sukadeva Goswami 接着就说这个故事。
And he's explaining to Maharaj Parikshit. He tells him, he said, since Narada Muni is a saintly person, so when he was...
他说, Nar,
So he got cursed by Prajapati Daksha.
他说 Narada Muni 是一位公认的圣人，但是他当时受到了 Prajapati Daksha 的诅咒。
So Narada Muni tells, he says to Daksha, he said, yes, what you have said is true, is good. What you have said is good.
Narada Muni 给 Daksha 说，你所说的一切都是好的。
And Narada Muni said to Daksha, I accept this curse.
我接受这个诅咒。
Now Narada Muni, he could have cursed Daksha back in return, because Daksha cursed him, he could have cursed him back.
然而其实南尔达穆里他是有能力能够相应的去诅咒Prajapati Daksha 的。
But because Narada Muni is a sadhu, and because he's very tolerant, he didn't take any action.
但是由于南尔达穆里他是一位真正的圣人，他是一位圣人sadhu，所以他并没有采取任何的行动。
So it's the nature of a sadhu, one of the qualities of a sadhu is that they're very tolerant and merciful.
一位圣人或沙杜，他的征兆或者他的品质资格是他对所有人都非常的宽容。
This was described by Lord Kapila when he was speaking to his mother Devahuti.
这是主卡皮拉对他的母亲 Devahuti 的教导。
Because Devahuti, well, Lord Kapila was telling his mother that she should find a holy man, find a sadhu, and take shelter of him.
卡皮拉跟他的母亲说，你得找到一个圣人并托庇于他。
How to recognize a holy person?
但是如何去识别一位这样的圣人呢？
Therefore, Kapila quoted and listed the different qualities of a sadhu.
所以卡皮拉，主卡皮拉就把这个萨度的他的品质给列了出来。
And the first quality he mentions is tatikshava, meaning tolerant.
一位圣人的第一个品质是宽容、容忍。
One who is going to preach Krishna consciousness, he must be very tolerant.
一位要去传播 Krishna 知觉的人，他必须非常的容忍。
Other qualities are he should be merciful.
其他的品质是他得仁慈。
And he should be friendly to everyone, all living entities.
而且他对所有的生物体都非常的友好。
He has no enemies.
他没有敌人。
He's peaceful.
他平和。
And he follows the scriptures.
他遵循经典。
So all of his qualities are very attractive, very pleasing.
所有的这些品质都是非常有吸引力，而且令人愉悦的。
Narada Muni is the most advanced of all the sadhus. He's a very great devotee.
Narada Muni 是所有这些圣人之中最为精进的，他是非常伟大的奉献者。
When Prajapati cursed him, when Daksha cursed him, Narada Muni just stayed silent. He didn't say anything.
当 Prajapati Daksha 诅咒他的时候，他保持沉默，并没有说任何的事情。
So this is according to the teachings of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
这也是主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的教导。
Lord Chaitanya taught all the devotees must be tolerant, like a tree.
主 Chaitanya 告诉所有的奉献者，我们得像大树一样宽容。
Trinadapi sunichena tarorapi sahishnuna amanena manadena kirtaniya sadahari. We should be tolerant like a tree and offer all respects to others.
一个人应该像大树一样宽容，摒弃一切虚荣感，随时向所有的人致敬。
Think of ourselves lower than a straw in the street.
是自己低于路上的一棵茅草。
Devoid of all sense of false prestige.
摒弃一切所有的虚荣感，怀以谦卑的心态。
Ready to offer all respects to others.
准备向所有的人表示敬意。
And in this way, one should chant the holy name of the Lord constantly.
以如此的心态，一个人才能持续不断地唱诵主的圣名。
Anybody who is preaching, like in the mood of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they have to be tolerant.
任何一个遵循主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的训令去传播的人，他都应该宽容、容忍。
Lower, humbler than the grass, more tolerant than the tree.
比大树要宽容，比小草要谦卑。
So, someone who is traveling and preaching is not a very easy life.
一个旅行而且又传播的人，他的生活不是那么的容易。
There will be many problems.
他会有各种各样的问题，遇到各种各样的障碍。
Sometimes he will be cursed.
有时他会受到诅咒。
Sometimes he'll be injured.
有时他得受伤。
Just like Lord Nityananda was preaching and he was attacked by Jagai and Madhai. They hit him on the head with a pot, drew blood from his head.
就像主李田南达去传播的时候，他向加盖和马代传播的时候，他被他们所伤，而且头流血了。
But Lord Nityananda tolerated.
但是主李田南达容忍了这一切。
And he prayed to Lord Chaitanya to deliver them, not to punish them.
他主尼天丹的给主柴坦尼亚说，请原谅他们，不要惩罚他们。
So by the mercy of Lord Nityananda, the two people, Jagai and Madai, they became devotees. They became very nice Vaishnavas.
在主尼天丹的仁慈下，他们成为了一位奉献者，成为了一位 Vaishnava。
Because Lord Nityananda was so tolerant, by his mercy they could be changed.
因为主尼天丹的 Prabhu 非常的仁慈，由于他的仁慈和容忍，这两位人改变了。
In the same way, Jesus Christ, he was put on the cross and he had to suffer so much terrible treatment.
主耶稣也被钉到了十字架上，遭受到很可怕的对待。
But Lord Jesus prayed to the Father. He said, Father, forgive them. They don't know what they're doing.
但是主耶稣给他的父亲说我的父亲啊，他们什么都不知道，请原谅他们。
And when Haridas Thakur was beaten in the marketplaces, Haridas Thakur also prayed to Lord Krishna that don't punish the people who are beating me.
当 Haridas Thakur 在十二个市场被鞭打的时候，他也向主 Krishna 祈祷，请不要去惩罚那些鞭打我的人。
These are some examples of the tolerance of a devotee.
这些是一些关于奉献者容忍的例子。
So when Narada Muni was cursed, it was not surprising.
因此，当 Narada Muni 遭到诅咒的时候，他并没有很惊讶。
And he tolerated it. He accepted it. He said, "Okay, you want to curse me? I accept the curse."
而且，当他受到诅咒时，他说：“好的，我接受这个诅咒。”
This shows the very pure qualities of Narada Muni.
这里展示了 Narada Muni 非常纯洁的品质。
Srila Prabhupada raises a question. He asks about why would Narada Muni stay in front of Daksha to be cursed?
Narada Muni 在这里提了一个问啊不，圣帕帕德在这里提了一个问题，为什么当 Narada Muni 受到诅咒的时候，他还一直站在 Daksha 的面前接受这个诅咒呢？
He had to listen to Daksha accuse him so many things, and then he had to be cursed by Daksha. Narada Muni could have just avoided Daksha. He could have just stayed away.
Narada Muni 本可以避免然后离开这个地方，但是他为什么要站在 Daksha 的面前接受他的谩骂和诅咒呢？
So what was Narada's thinking? Why was he staying around?
那 Narada Muni 当时正在想什么呢？他为什么要这么做呢？
Did he just simply, he wanted simply to see Daksha delivered?
他只是想看Daksha 他的受的得到能够脱离愤怒吗？
So Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, who's a great acharya in our line of disciplic succession, he said yes. Narada Muni just wanted to see Daksha delivered.
Oh, Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti, 就是我们这个师徒传习的一位临行导师说，是的， Narada Muni 真的想去让 Daksha 得到解脱。
So.Narada Muni should have left immediately, but he stayed there to hear Daksha, to hear Daksha's complaints.
Narada Muni 本可以立即就离开，但是他留下来完整的听了 Daksha 的这一番愤怒的发泄。
Daksha was making complaints that he wanted, and Narada Muni wanted Daksha to get rid of all of his bad feelings towards Narada Muni.
Narada Muni 希望 Daksha 能够免除所有的这些愤对他的这些气愤和愤怒。
Daksha was not an ordinary person.
Daksha 并不是一个普通人。
He is a Prajapati. That's a big position in the universe.
他是一位祖先，他在整个宇宙中拥有很大的地位。
And he got that position because he'd done a lot of pious activities.
他之所以能够取得这样的位置，是因为他做了很多的虔诚活动。
Narada Muni was hoping.That after Daksha cursed him, then Daksha would be satisfied and he would be free from anger.
Narada Muni 是这么想的，他觉得他认为 Daksha 在诅咒和谩骂他完之后，他能够满足，然后并摆脱这种愤怒。
And after he gets over his anger, then he'll feel sorry about his behavior.
在他把他的这些愤怒摆脱掉之后，他会对他之前的所作所为感觉到忏悔。
And then he'd think about becoming a devotee.
这样他就会想着要成为一位奉献者。
Just like Jagai and Madai, when they offended Lord Nityananda.
就像加盖和马代，当他冒犯了主尼天南达的时候。
So,When Lord Nityananda was hit, Lord Nityananda just stood there. He just stood there before the two brothers. He tolerated.
主尼天南达就站在他们两兄弟的面前，而且容忍了这一切，容忍了他两兄弟对他所做的一切事情。
So when Lord Nityananda just stood there and tolerated it, then Jagai and Madai understood that Lord Nityananda was really a great devotee.
当主尼天南达站在他们面前，容忍了他们所做的一切事情之后，加盖和马代理解到他主尼天南达是一位非常伟大的奉献者。
And then Jagai and Madai they fell at the feet of Lord Nityananda and they begged to be forgiven.
然后加盖和马代就拜倒在他的莲花足下，请求主尼天南达的原谅。
And this way they became great devotees.
如此。这两位，这加盖和马代就成为奉献者。
Okay, so then Sukadeva Goswami said, he's talking to Maharaj Parikshit. He said, so at the request of Lord Brahma, Prajapati Daksha, after having all of his sons renounce the world.Next is he has his wife give birth to daughters instead of sons.
Sukadeva Goswami 接着给 Parikshit Maharaj 说，当应 Brahma 的要求，当 Prajapati Daksha 失去了他所有的儿子，当他们的儿子进入到气绝阶层之后，他放弃了去继续繁衍儿子，开始想去繁衍女儿了。
Yeah, this was the advice of Lord Brahma.He told him, instead of having sons, just produce daughters in the womb of your wife.
这也是主 Brahma 的建议。你可以现在从你的妻子那里去繁衍一些女儿。
So Daksha, he put 60 daughters into the womb of his wife.
Daksha 通过他妻子的子宫得到了60个女儿。
Right. His first children were 10,000 sons, and then 1,000 sons, and they all renounced, and then he had daughters, 60 daughters.
Daksha 第一批是一万个儿子，第二批是一千个儿子，现在他又得到了60个女儿。
And all these daughters were very attached to their father.
所有的这些女儿对 Daksha 都非常依附。
So after Daksha had lost all of his sons to Narada Muni, Lord Brahma thought this would be a good thing to do. Let Daksha have daughters instead of sons.
当 Daksha 失去了所有的这些儿子之后，主 Brahma 这时候来告诉 Daksha， 与其繁衍儿子，这个时候不如去繁衍女儿。
Daksha, he was very careful to produce daughters instead of boys, because he knows if he have more boys, Narada Muni may try to take them away again.
Daksha 这个时候非常谨慎小心地繁衍出女儿而不是男孩，他这样做的目的是防止 Narada Muni 去打扰他们。
But girls are not supposed to renounce the world.
因为女孩她不被期望进入到弃绝阶层。
Girls are supposed to get married and have a husband, and they should be faithful to their husbands.
女孩应该结婚，然后对她的丈夫忠诚。
And they should be married to a good husband. That means a husband who is a good devotee.
她如果她要去就是说她应该找一位优秀的丈夫结婚，意味着她的丈夫应该是一个奉献者。
And if the husband, if he's good devotee, he'll go back to Godhead, and then the wife will also go. She'll go with him.
如果丈夫是一位奉献者，能够回归守神的话，那么这一位妻子也能够回归守神，跟她的丈夫一起走。
In the scriptures, it says that whatever pious activities a man does, he will share with his wife.
经典说，如果丈夫所做的任何的虔诚活动，妻子将会自动分享。
So a woman's duty is to be very chaste and faithful to her husband.
女人的职责就是对丈夫无比的贞洁和忠诚。
And when she follows, when she's like that, when she's faithful to her husband, then she will share all the pious activities of her husband.
如果她对她的丈夫很忠诚的话，她无需额外的努力，就能自动获得她丈夫所有的益处。
Of course, if the husband does a lot of sinful things, then the wife will also share.
当然，如果这个丈夫也做了一些罪恶的活动的话，这位妻子也会承担她丈夫，也会分担她丈夫的这些结果。
So you have to be very careful.
所以都得非常小心。
So then, but Daksha has 60 daughters, so he gave 10 daughters in charity to Yamaraj.
Daksha 有六十位女儿，她把十个女儿，其中的十个女儿布施给了 Yamaraj。
And then to Kashyapa, he gave 13 daughters.
他布施了十三个女儿给 Kashyapa Muni.
First of all, he gave him 12, and then he gave him one more.
起初布施了十二个，然后又增加了一个。
Then 27 daughters of Daksha were given to the moon god Chandra.
还有二十七个女儿布施给了月神。
And then 2 daughters each were given to these 3 sages.
还有两个女儿布施给了这些圣人们。
Angira, Krishashva.And Buddha.
And 布施给了 Angira, Krishashva 各两个。
Krishashva and Buddha.
Krishashva 和 Buddha 各两个女儿。
And then there were 4 other daughters. They were given to Kashyapa.
剩下的四个女儿布施给了 Kashyapa.
So we already gave Kashyapa 13, so he got 4 more, so total he got 17 daughters for his wives.
前面已经布施给了 Kashyapa Muni 有13个，后面又布施了4个，所以总共给 Kashyapa 有17个女儿。
So Sukadeva Goswami is going to tell us the names of all these daughters.
Shukadeva Goswami 接下来会为我们讲述这些女儿的名字。
And he said their descendants, they filled up all the universe, all the three worlds.
他说他们的这些后代不及整个三个世界，充满了三个世界。
So there were 10 daughters given to Yamaraj.
首先是十个布施给 Yamaraj 的女儿。
So I'll say the names. Banu,
我来说这些，
Banu, Lamba, Kakud, Yami, Vishwa, Swadhyaya, Marudvati, Vashu, Muhurta, and Sankalpa.
巴鲁、朗巴、卡库、亚米、维什瓦、萨迪亚、马图瓦提、瓦苏、穆胡塔、桑考帕。
Sukadeva Goswami said, "Now you'll tell us the names of their sons."
Sukadeva Goswami 现在给我们讲述这些女儿们他们的儿子。
So there was a son named Deva Rishabha, was born from the womb of Banu. And from him came a son named Indrasena.
首先是一位名叫 Rishabhadeva 的儿子诞生自 Manu 的子宫，从他又繁衍出一个儿子名叫 Indrasena.
Then from the womb of Lamba came a son named Vidyota, who generated all the clouds.
从 Lamba 的子宫诞生出一个儿子名叫 Vidyota, 他诞生出所有的云朵。
Then from the womb of Kakud came the son named Sankata, whose son was named Kikata.
从 Kakud 的子宫诞生出的儿子名叫 Sankata, 他的儿子名叫 Ikata.
From Kikata,came the demigods named Durga. From Yami came the son named Swarga, whose son was named Nandi.
Kikata 繁衍出名叫 Durga 的半神人， Yami 生下一个儿子名叫 Shrigar, 他的儿子名叫 Nandi. Swarga.
Then the sons of Vishwa were the Vishwadevas, who had no progeny. From the womb of Sadhya came the Sadhyas, who had a son named Artasiddhi.
Vishwa 的儿子名字是 Vishwadeva, 他们没有后代。从 Sadhya 的子宫诞生出 Sadhyas,Sadhyas 有一儿子名叫 Artasiddhi.
The two sons who took birth from the womb of Marudvati were Marudvan and Jayanta. Jayanta, who is an expansion of Lord Vasudev, is known as Upendra.
从 Marudvati 的子宫诞生出了两个儿子，名是 Maratvan 和 Jayanta. Jayanta 是主 Vasudeva 的一个扩展，他也以 Upendra 著称。
Then the demigods named the Muhurtikas took birth from the womb of Muhurta. These demigods delivered the results of action to the living entities.Of their respective times.
名叫 Muhurtika 的半神人诞生自 Muhurta 的子宫，这些半神人把活动的结果交给他们各自时期的生物体。
The sons of Sankalpa were known as Sankalpa, and from him lust was born.
Sankalpa 的儿子被誉为 Sankalpa, 从他那儿产生出色欲。
The sons of Vasu were known as the eight Vasus. Just hear their names from me. Drona, Prana, Dhruva, Arka, Agni, Dosha, Vastu, and Vibha Vasu. From Abhimati, the wife of the Vasu named Drona, were generated the sons called Harsha, Shoka, Baya, and so on.
Vasu 的儿子们以八瓦苏著称，听我说他们的名字：多纳、帕纳、朱瓦、阿尔塔、阿尔卡、阿格尼、多萨、瓦斯图、维巴瓦苏。名叫多纳的瓦苏之妻阿比马提生的儿子名叫哈尔沙、舒卡、巴雅等等。
Urjasvati, the wife of Prana, gave birth to three sons.Named Saha, Ayush, and Purojava. Purojava, the wife of Dhruva, was known as Dharani, and from her womb, various cities took birth.
Pana 的妻子 Urjasvati 生下三个儿子，名叫 Saha, Ayu, Purojava.朱瓦的妻子名叫达如阿尼，从她的子宫产生出各种各样的城市。
From the womb of Vasana, the wife of Arka, came many sons, headed by Tarsha, Dara, the wife of the Vasu named Agni, gave birth to many sons, headed by Dravinaka.
从瓦沙的妻子阿尔卡的子宫诞生出很多儿子，他们是以塔尔沙为首。达拉是名叫阿格尼的瓦苏之妻，她生下很多儿子，以卓维纳卡为首。
Then from Kriti, from Kritika, Kritika, another wife of Agni.Came the son named Skanda, Kartikeya, whose sons were headed by Vishakha. From the womb of Sarvari, the wife of the Vasu named Dosha, came the son named Sishumara, who was an expansion of the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Agni 的另外一个妻子 Kritiya 的儿子名叫Skanda, Kartiya 的儿子们以 Vishakha 为首，从名叫 Dosha 的 Vasu 之妻 Sarvari 的子宫出生的儿子名叫 Sri Shumar, 他是至尊人格首生的一个扩展。
From Angirasi, the wife of the Vasu named Vastu,was born the great architect Vishwakarma. Vishwakarma became the husband of Akriti, from whom the Manu named Chakshusha was born. The sons of Manu were known as the Vishwadevas and Sajyas.
名叫 Vastu 的 Vasu 之妻 Angirasi 生下了伟大的建筑师 Vishwakarma.Vishwakarma 成为了 Akriti 的丈夫， Akriti 生下了 Chakshusha 的 Manu， Manu 的儿子们被誉为 Vishwadeva 和 Shadya。
Usha, the wife of Vibhavasu, gave birth to three sons, Vyusta, Rochisa, and Atapa. From Atapa came Panchayama,the span of day who awakens all living entities to material activities.
Vibhavasu 的妻子 Usha 生下三个儿子 Vyusta, Rochisa 和 Atapa. Atapa 产生出 Panchayama, 也就是白昼，它唤起所有生物体的物质活动。
Sarupa, the wife of Buddha,gave birth to the 10 million Rudras, of whom the 11 principal Rudras were Raivata, Aja, Bhava, Bhima, Vama, Ugra, Vrishakapi, Ajaykapat, Ahir Pradhana, Bahu Rupa, and Mahan. Their associates, the ghosts and goblins, who are very fearful, were born of the other wife of Buddha.
Buddha's 妻子 Sarupa 生出了一千万个 Rudra， 其中十一个主要的 Rudra 是 Raivata、Aja、Bava、Bima、Vama、Ugra、Vishakapi、Asikapat、Ahibuddana、Bahurupa 和 Mahan。他们的同游幽灵和鬼怪令人感到恐惧，他们由 Buddha 的其他妻子所生。
So Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur says that Buddha had two wives. One of them, Sarupa, gave birth to the 11 Rudras, and the other wife gave birth to the associates of the Rudras, known as the ghosts and hobgoblins.
Shri Vishwanath Chakravarti 在这里说，这位 Buddha 有两个妻子，一个是 Sarupa 生了十一个 Rudra， 另外一个妻子生了 Rudra 的同游，称为幽灵和鬼怪。
Then the Prajapati Angira had two wives named Swada and Sati. The wife named Swada accepted all the Pitas as her sons, and Sati accepted the Atharvangirasha Veda as her son.
Prajapati Angira 有两个妻子，名叫 Swada 和 Sati。名叫 Swada 的妻子把所有的 Pita 都接受为他自己的儿子，而 Sati 把Artavangirasa Veda 接受为他自己的儿子。
Then Krishasva had two wives named Archis and Deshana, and in the wife named Archis he begot Dhumaketu, and in Deshana he begot four sons named Vedasira, Devala, Vayuna and Manu.
Krishna 有两个妻子，名叫 Archi 和 Deshana。通过名叫 Archi 的妻子，他得到的 Dhumaketu。通过 Deshana， 他得到了四个儿子，名叫 Vedash、Devala、Vayuna 和 Manu。
Kashyapa, who is also known as Tarksha, had four wives.Vinata or Suparna, Kadru, Patangi, and Yamini. Patangi gave birth to many kinds of birds, and Yamini gave birth to locusts. Vinata or Suparna gave birth to Garuda, the carrier of Lord Vishnu, and toAnurud, or Aruna, the chariot driver of the sun god. Kadru gave birth to different varieties of serpents.
Kashyapa, 也叫 Tarksha, 他有四个妻子 Vinata, 或者也叫 Suparna, Kadru,Pantangi, Yamini. Pantangi 生出了许多的鸟类， Yamini 生育出了蝗虫， Vinata 生出了主威士努的坐骑 Garuda， 以及 Anuru, Aruna 太阳神的车夫， Kadru 生出了各种不同的蛇类。
O Maharaj Parikshit, best of the Bharatas, the constellations named Kritika were all wives of the moon god. However, because Prajapati Daksha had cursed him to suffer from a disease causing gradual destruction, the moon god could not beget children in any of his wives.
Oh, Maharaj Parikshit, Bharat 的佼佼者，名叫 Kritiya 的 Kritiya Kritika 的群体是全体全是月神的妻子。然而 Prajapati Daksha 诅咒了月神，经受了一种导致逐渐毁灭的疾病，所以月神不能从他那里的任何一个妻子那里得到孩子。
Purport. Because the moon god was very much attached to Rohini, he neglected all his other wives. Therefore, seeing the bereavement of these daughters, Prajapati Daksha became angry and cursed him.
这里的要旨是月神由于非常依附 Rohini， 因此忽略了其他的妻子。看到了女儿的痛苦之后， Prajapati Daksha 非常的愤怒，诅咒了她。
So the moon god had, you see, he'd married many wives of, he married many daughters of Daksha, right? He'd married 27 or something daughters of Daksha?
Yes, 27.
Anyway, he'd married many daughters, but he was more attached to one of them. This one, Rohini, she was very beautiful. And gave her a lot of attention and neglected the other wives.
月神娶了 Prajapati Daksha 的很多的女儿，总共有大概27个。但是呢，月神由于非常依附其中的一个女儿 Rohini， 所以就忽略了其他的妻子。其他的妻子就感觉到痛苦。当 Daksha 发现了这一切之后，他为自己的女儿的这样的一个遭遇感觉到非常的愤怒，于是就诅咒了月神。
So as a result of the curse Daksha put on the moon god wasn't able to have children in any of his wives.
由于这个诅咒，月神就不能从其他的这些妻子，从他的这些妻子那里得到孩子了。
So these wives, they were all the constellations named Kritika.
月神的这一些妻子，是以 Kritika 的群体为首。
So thereafter, the king of the moon pacified Prajapati Daksha with nice words.
后来，月神就对 Prajapati Daksha 说了很多很好听的话语。
And when he did that, then Daksha was pacified, and Daksha didn't curse him. The curse didn't take so much effect, and the moon god got back the light which he had lost. When he got cursed with the disease, then he lost some of his light.But after he got friendly with Daksha again, then he got back that light.
当月神对 Prajapati Daksha 说了一些很好听的优美的话语的时候， Prajapati Daksha 心中的愤怒宣泄了一些。就这样， Prajapati Daksha 月神他的光芒重新恢复了一些，因为在之前他受到 Prajapati Daksha 诅咒之后，他自身的光芒就损失了。但是当 Prajapati Daksha 心情好了，他的光芒就恢复了一部分。
But he couldn't, still he couldn't, wasn't able to have children.
但是他仍然不能得到孩子。
So we see the moon.It has two periods. There's a dark fortnight and the bright fortnight in every month.
月亮在每一个月都会有月缺的两次。
For 2 weeks, the moon loses, it becomes less bright, becomes dark, and then for 2 weeks, then it begins to become brighter and brighter.
月亮在月缺的两个星期会逐渐的失去自己的光芒，然后在月满的两个星期，它的光芒，它的璀璨又会再一次展示出来。
So now Sukadeva Goswami tells Maharaj Parikshit, I want to tell you the names of Kashyapa's wives.
Sukadeva Goswami 准备给 Parikshit Maharaj 现在讲述 Kashyapa 的这些妻子的名字。
And he said, from the wombs of all these wives, the population of the whole universe has come.
从 Kashyapa 的妻子的子宫产生出整个宇宙的人口。
They're the mothers of all the different species of living entities throughout the universe.
他们是整个宇宙几乎全部人口的母亲。
And their names are very auspicious. Just to hear their names is auspicious.
仅仅是聆听他们的名字都非常的吉祥。
So their names are Aditi, Diti, Danu, Kashta, Arishta, Surasa, Ila, Muni, Krod Bhavasha, Tambra, Surabhi, Sarana, and Tima, Tini.
他们的名字是 Aditi, Diti, Danu, Kashta,Arista, Surasha, Ila, Muni, Krodavasha, Tara, Surabhi, Sarama, and Timi.
Then from the womb of Timi, all the aquatics took birth.
从 Timi 的子宫繁衍出所有的水族。
And from Sarana,the ferocious animals like tigers and lions took birth.
从 Sarama 的子宫繁衍出像老虎和狮子之类的这样凶猛的动物。
Okay, so I think we'll stop here now. That's a good place to stop.
Okay, 我们今天先讲到这儿。
Okay, are there questions tonight?
Yes. First question from Zhen Zhen. Hare Krishna, 亲爱的 Guru Maharaj, 顶拜您的甜美的莲花组，顶拜翻译和主持人所有的奉献者。丈夫和妻子是不是业力共同承担？丈夫承担妻子的，妻子也要承担丈夫的。Hare Krishna, basis to Guru Maharaj's sweet lotus feet. I want to ask, the husband and wife,Are they respond the karma together? The husband will respond for the wife's karma, and the wife will also respond for the husband's karma.
Yes.
是的。
They share each other's pious and sinful activities.
他们共同分享承担各自的好的以及罪恶的活动。Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Yuna. Hare Krishna, good day. Please accept my humble basis. How can a devotee remain patient if he is criticized for participating in Krishna consciousness?Hare Krishna Guru Day, 请接受我卑微的顶拜。一个奉献者如何能够保持耐心？如果他在 Krishna 加入 Krishna 知觉的运动中受到了批评，他如何能够保持耐心和容忍？
Well, it depends who's criticizing you.
这个取决于他是如何批评你的呢？
If it's are they devotees or not devotees?
这个，Hare Gurudev, you mean who is devotee or not devotee?
No, the people criticizing, are they devotees?
Oh, okay. 这个批评你的这个人到底是奉献者呢，还是非奉献者？
Are they your employers or? Are they relatives, or what's their relationship with you?
他是你的雇主吗？或者说是你的朋友吗？或者说是你的亲戚吗？你们之间的关系又是怎样？
You have to be careful who you let know you're a devotee.
你应该小心谁 who you let know you're a devotee. Sorry, Gurudev.
You should not tell anybody who, that you should not tell people that you're a devotee.
Okay. 你不必要告诉每一个人你是一个奉献者。
There are many people who are against our movement.
有很多人反对我们这个运动。
And if they know you're a devotee, then they may be angry at you.
如果他们知道你是一个奉献者的话，或许他们就会对你很生气了。
You have to be very careful.
所以你就得很小心。
Some people may want to take your job.And they're looking for some reason to find fault with you. So this could be a reason to find fault with you.
有一些人盯着你的工作在，所以如果你是一个奉献者，他可能就从以此来挑你的毛病。
So you have to be very careful.
所以就得很小心。
So I don't know. Somebody is criticizing you.
所以我不知道是不是有人批评你呢。
You have to tell me who are they? Why are they criticizing you?
你得告诉我他们为什么批评你，他们怎么批评你。
They don't like Hare Krishna. That's why.
他们不喜欢这个 Hare Krishna， 这就是他们的原因吗？
Maybe they like that. Maybe they're devotees of the Russian Orthodox Church, and they see you are a Hare Krishna, so they don't like you.
或许他们是俄罗斯的这个某些教堂的这些人，所以因为你是 Hare Krishna， 他们就不喜欢你。
So you should be very careful.
所以你得很小心。Next question from Sugita Sangha Mataji. Dimbai Guru 的莲花族，感恩翻译和主持人甜美服务。请教 Guru， 一个奉献者女人还会承担丈夫的善恶活动吗？离婚的女人自己生活、潜心修行，是否属于弃绝 ？Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. I want to ask a devotee woman, will also shall the husband good or sinful activities?
Yes, if she's married to a man, husband and wife, they share each other's karma.
是的，如果一个女人，她和另外一个奉献者女人，她和另外一个人结婚，他们是会承担他们彼此之间的这种业报。If a woman divorces and he lives alone and practices Krishna consciousness, is she a renounce?
Yes.
如果一个女人就是说弃绝，她潜心自己修行，她是属于弃绝。
Yes, she is renounce.
她属于弃绝。
She is independent. She is not.She doesn't take any sinful reactions from the husband anymore.
她已经独立了，这个离婚了之后，她已经独立了，她再也不承担她丈夫的这些罪恶活动。
But if the husband gives her money, if she's getting money from the husband, then there's some karma there.
如果她从她的丈夫那里接受一些钱的话，那里面是有一些业报。Next question from Rajan. 智性可以通过苦行提升吗？ The intelligence can be improved by the tapasya?
Yes. But the austerity you do has to be in the mode of goodness.
但是你做的这个苦行必须是在善良属性的情态下做的这种苦行。
Right. There's different levels of austerity. Austerity could be in goodness, in passion, or in ignorance.
因为苦行也分三种层面，有激情形态、愚昧形态以及善良形态的苦行。
Yeah, so you have to say if somebody is torturing their body, so that's not good.
有一些人残害自己的躯体，这个不是很好的。
And if somebody is doing austerity just to get name and fame, to get respect, that's not good. That's the mode of passion.
如果还有一些人他做苦行是为了得到名声，名声各种各样的名誉，或者说一些其他的东西的话，这个苦行它是属于激情形态的，也是不好的。
But if somebody is doing austerity in the mode of goodness, that's for the pleasure of the Supreme Lord.
如果有一些人苦行，他是为了至尊主的快乐的话，这是属于善良形态。
That would be things like fasting on Ekadasi, that's in the mode of goodness, or observing Chaturmasya, that's in the mode of goodness.
比如说在阿克达西戒时，比如说在查图玛夏四月苦行之类，遵循这个誓言等等，这个都属于善良形态的苦行。
Or Purushottam Mas, or Damodariya, like that. If you do some fasting, you do some, make some vow to do more chanting at that time. That's the mode of goodness.
或者说在普鲁舍塔玛月或达摩达尔月的时间做一些誓言。更多的念诵，有一些戒食等等，这样的一些誓言是在善良心态。
OK，
新人参加几次联谊还说没有信心，请问新人要以什么样的心态参加联谊？怎样做对他们能够带来帮助呢 ？The new people associate many times, but he cannot get the faith.So I want to ask how the new people with what kind of mood participate in our association, then he can get the benefits.
Well, if they just come and participate in the association, they get benefit.
如果他们来参加我们的联谊，只是来参加我们的联谊，他们都能得到好处。
If they come and they sit in the program and they hear,a lecture and they chant and they eat prasadam, that means they have some faith.
如果他来参加我们的联谊，坐着去聆听唱诵，去唱诵，然后来吃我们的菩萨等，这些行为都表明他是有信心的。
You cannot say they don't have faith.
你不能说他没有信心。
Yeah, they have faith. They're coming. They're attending the program. They're with you, hearing the chanting.They've got faith.
他们是有信心的。他们来参加活动的。他们来和你在一起，和你一起唱诵，和你一起聆听，和你一起吃prasadam。这些都是他们信心的表现。
Anybody who takes prasadam means they have faith.
任何来吃prasadam的人，他们意味着他们是有信心的。
Yeah.
Yes. Next question from Shyamalata Madanji. 顶拜孤的莲花族，感恩翻译和主持人甜美福，请教孤乳。夫妻两人，妻子是奉献者，丈夫不是，是不是无论妻子修习 Krishna 直觉，都无法达到 Krishna 的莲花族呢 ？Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. I want to ask the husband and wife.The wife is devotee, but husband are not devotees. So I want to ask, whatever the wife practice Krishna consciousness, how much, 这个妻子无论怎么样修行， it cannot achieve the perfection of the Krishna consciousness.
Well, it's up to Krishna.
这个取决于主 Krishna.
He has to look at the heart and see.
我们得看一看他的内心。
He will see, is a woman attached to Krishna? Is Krishna in, is, have you got love of Krishna in your heart?
我们得看一看这个妻子是否是得到了对 Krishna 的爱，在她心里有没有对 Krishna 的爱。
Is it love for your husband? Is it love of the body or love of his soul?
她到底是爱这个自己的躯体呢，还是爱这个灵魂呢？
No, Bosha. Does a woman love her husband's body or does she love her husband's soul?
她是爱她丈夫的躯体呢，还是爱丈夫的灵魂呢？
So Krishna will consider what's your qualification.
所以 Krishna 会考虑你的资格是什么。
Anyway, once you get 50 and over, you have to retire.
无论如何，当一个人到五十岁以后，他应该退休。
You have to prepare for the next life.
你得为下一世做准备。
The husband is a material relationship.
这个丈夫是一种物质的关系。
You have to develop your spiritual relationship.
你们得发展 you have to
develop your spiritual relationships.
你得发展灵性的关系。
Your relationship with Krishna.
你和 Krishna 的灵性这种关系。
That's eternal relationship.
这个是永恒的关系。
Husband is temporary.
你的丈夫是短暂的。
And once you're 50, then you're old. That relationship is not very important.
当你到五十岁的时候，你已经年老了，意味着这种关系不是特别的重要。
You're not going to have any more children.
你们不再需要去要更多的小孩。
So your material duties are finished.
因此你物质的职责已经结束了。
You have to concentrate more on your spiritual duties.
你得更专注于你灵性的职责。
You don't neglect your husband. You stay with your husband.
你不必忽略你的丈夫，但是你可以和你的丈夫在一起。
Yeah, you don't have to leave him. You stay with him.
你不必离开他，你可以和他待在一起。
But your purpose, your real focus is on spiritual practice.
但是你的目标，你的专注点在 Krishna 的休息中。
Okay.
Okay, next question from Lolo. Hare Krishna, 顶拜孤的莲花族，顶拜翻译，顶拜奉献者们。既然说丈夫的所有益处，妻子都能受益，罪恶活动也同样是。那么，如果一个非常苦行的妻子的益处或罪恶，是不是丈夫也同样受益或承担？经典说，妈的姐应该找个丈夫做好丈夫的一切。应该找个丈夫，然后做好对丈夫的一切活动。但是现实社会来说，很多家庭女性在修习 Krishna 知觉之中居多，好多帕布对 Krishna 知觉都没有信心，都需要靠妻子的各种方法来引导，而且也不一定能找到可以服务的那个丈夫。还有一个问题，只有帕布拥有去意决权吗？从来没有见过 Mother 级的咕噜。Hare Krishna, basis to Guru's lotus feet. It is said that whatever the husband do, the the wife will share the pious activities and the sinful activities also. So if a wife do many austerities, the husband will also share the benefit
of
sinful activities. 是的，丈夫也会承担这个，丈夫也会分享或承担丈夫或承担丈承担妻子所做的这些益处和罪恶的这个活动。And then she asked, "It is said that the mother should find a husband and should do everything for the husband, but in reality, in nowadays, many families.The women are practice the Krishna consciousness, but many Prabhus, they don't have faith in Krishna consciousness. And we can't find that a husband, can't find that good husband can be served. So my question is just the Prabhu have the renunciation?Is just a Prabhu have the power of the have the right of the renunciation? I've never heard the Mataji Guru.
Women can also be renounced.
女性也可以弃绝。
They don't take sannyas. They don't travel and preach. They can stay in one place and just practice Krishna consciousness.
他不用接受三亚西启迪，也不用旅行，他只需要待在一个地方休息 Krishna 知觉。
And they can be single women, they can be alone, they may be widows, they may be unmarried, they can be renounced.
他可以是一个单身的女性，他可以不用结婚，他可以保持他的气绝。
有的是寡妇。
有的是寡妇。
So, they're renounced. Their focus is on devotional service. They give up sense gratification.
他们发展的 Krishna 知觉，然后放弃感官享乐，他们保持他们的气绝。
So women can also be like gurus, they can be, usually they don't give diksha, but they can give shiksha.
通常情况下女性也可以成为灵性导师，也可以成为 guru, 但是她不是得到这种 diksha 的启迪 guru, 或但是她可以给予训示。
We don't see any women become the chairman of the Communist Party.
我们没有见过在共产 Communist Party 在共产国家有这个
没有见过女的主席。
女主席。
都是男的。So in the same way, you know, usually men.They do the duty of spiritual teachers.
同样的，通常情况下是男性来作为这个灵性的导师。
But in the history, in the past, there were some women who were also gurus.
但是在过去确实有这么一些历史，有女性成为 guru.
There was one woman, she was the former wife of Lord Nityananda.So after Lord Nityananda left the world, she became a guru.
有一位是朱尼天丹娜的妻子，当朱尼天丹离开这个世界之后，她成为了灵性导师。
Janava, her name was Janava.
她的名字是 Janava.
And then there was also another lady, she was the daughter of one of the great preachers in the Gaudiya Vaishnava Sampradaya. She was the daughter of Shiva, Srinivas Acharya.
还有一个是 Srinivas Acharya 的女儿，在我们高地亚 Vaishnava 师徒传奇中，她也是。
His daughter was called Hemalata Thakurani.
她的名字叫 Hemalata Thakurani.
She was a very powerful, very great devotee.
她也是一位非常有力量的奉献者。
And she had some disciples.
她也有一些门徒。
But it's very uncommon.
但这不是普遍的。
Yes.
Yes. Next question from Shyama. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Maharaj 和所有奉献者。Daksha 的女儿是人类，为什么会嫁给鸟类等动物，生出动物呢？ Hare Krishna, obeisances to Guru Maharaj. Daksha's daughter is human.Why she married to the bird and give birth to some animals?
Well, these were not ordinary women. These were demigods. These ladies were all the daughters of Daksha. And Daksha, remember, was a prajapati. So his duty was to fill up all the different population, different species of life in the universe.Not just only humans, he was to arrange for all the other species of life also to take birth.
Prajapati Daksha, 他是一位祖先，他的这些女儿有一些是半神人，所以呢，他的职责是为了能够让整个宇宙有各种各样的生物体出现，所以他不仅仅只是繁衍人类，也要繁衍其他的生物体。
Yeah, they were not humans, they were demigods from the higher planets.
他们不是人类，他们是半神人，来自于高等的星球。
And when they give birth, many times they would give birth, it would be from the mind.
当他们繁衍人口的时候，很多时候他们是通过心意就繁衍了。
We just heard Daksha's wife was giving birth 10,000 sons.1,000 sons, and then 60 daughters.
我们之前听过 Daksha 他繁衍了10,000个儿子、1,000个儿子，然后60个女儿。
So then the other species also came. We heard all the aquatics came from her, from the womb, from her womb. All the aquatics came, and from somebody else, all the serpents came.
我们今天也听到有其他的一些生物体，比如说蛇啊，还有其他的一些动物啊等等，水族啊，这样都繁衍出来。
So we're hearing how these different living entities came about. It wasn't by evolution.
我们将会听到，我们听到这些生物体它是怎么出来的。
Was not by evolution.
Evolution was mean good day.
Darwin, Lilun, 那个。
哦，它这个不是进哦，不是进化出来的，是繁衍出来的。这些生物体是繁衍出来的，各种各样的生物体是繁衍出来的，而不是我们所听到的由达尔文的这个理论进化出来的。
So we're getting a systematic explanation of how all the living entities came into existence in the universe.
我们有一个系统的知识，关于整个宇宙的不同的生物体，它是怎么样出现的。Next question from Hani Vamsa, Dimbai Guru. 这里提到的 Kashyapa 是不是瓦坎里经常提到的 Kashyapa Muni?Hare Krishna Guru, I want to ask, today we mentioned Kashyapa, is that the Kashyapa Muni the same person?
Yes, same person.
是的，就是那个 Kashyapa Muni.
He had many wives, right?
他有很多的妻子。
They were all the daughters of, many were the daughters of Daksha.
他们都是很多，他们都是 Daksha 的女儿。
People like Diti and Aditi, they were all married to Kashyapa.
Diti 和 Aditi, 他们都嫁给了 Kashyapa.
They wanted to marry him. They were all attracted to him.
他们都想嫁给 Kashyapa, 因为他们都被 Kashyapa 所吸引。
So their father Daksha arranged, let them get married to the man they're attracted to, then they'll be happy.
所以他们的父亲 Daksha 就安排了这场婚礼，让他们嫁给 Kashyapa. Next question from Vaishnava Vani, Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, my humble basis. Narada Muni plans what Daksha will went anger on him, and later on he will feel guilty and become a devotee. Daksha went on to the Lord Brahma, beget more daughters. So my doubt is, did Daksha feel guilty and became a devotee later? Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, 我的接受卑微的顶拜。Narada Muni 的计划是让 Daksha。让当时继续宣泄对他的这个愤怒，然后之后能够感到一点愧疚，最后成为一位奉献者。所以我这里的疑问是，当时是否感觉到愧疚并成为了一名奉献者呢？
We never heard that he became a devotee.
我们没有听到他后来成为一位奉献者。
He's a Prajapati, he's Daksha, he's expert in procreating, producing progeny.
他是一位 Daksha, 一位祖先，他的职责，他职责就是繁衍人口。
And he's a Grihavrat, he's made a vow to stay in the home, he's attached to family.
而且他是一位 Grihavrat,他发就是一位发了誓要留在家庭生活之中的人。
Of course, it's good he got all his daughters married. That's very nice.
当然，让他的这些妻，让他这些女儿都结婚了，繁衍的出的这些女儿都结婚了，这也是非常好的事情。
But you see, sometimes, just like some of them married to the moon god, and the moon god.He likes one of them more than the others. One of them is maybe more beautiful than the other daughters, and he spent more and gave more attention to Rohini because she was very beautiful.
就像当然这个里面也是有些问题的，比如说我们今天提到了他的这些女儿之中有一些嫁给了月神，但是月神只喜欢比较偏爱于 Rohini, 就造成了对其他妻子的忽视。
So even though you get your daughter married, it doesn't mean that she'll be happy, you know?
这里的要点是，这个意义是，即便你的女儿都结婚了，但并不意味着你女儿结婚之后你会快乐。
We can see.The girls were not so happy because the moon god is giving more attention to one of them and neglecting the others.
他的女儿不开心是因为月神只喜欢其中的这个一个，而对其他的妻子忽视了。
Yeah. Okay.
Next question from Yuna. Thank you very much for guidance and knowledge, Guru Maharaj. Next question from Mao Mao. 敬爱的 Guru Day, Daksha 会把女儿嫁给奉献者，为他们做安排。为什么他都见过了至尊主，却觉悟回归守神呢？还是至尊主不给予他这个使命呢 ？Obeisances to you, Guru Day. The Daksha give the doctors.And married her, these daughters all married to the devotees, and arrange the daughters. So why Daksha even he met the Supreme Lord, why he cannot have the realization of the go back to the Godhead, and is that the Lord didn't give the mission to Daksha?
Well, he gave another mission to Daksha. Daksha's mission was to populate the universe, to fill it up, to produce progeny.
至尊主给予了Daksha的另外一个使命，让他成为这个宇宙的祖先，去繁衍人口。
Yeah. So, different devotees have different missions to do, right? So, Daksha has another mission. His mission is not to go back to Godhead.
不同的奉献者有不同的使命，所以Daksha的使命，他不是觉悟至尊人格守身，回归守身。 Next question from Sati Madhaji. 顶拜 Guru Maharaj, 请问在四月苦行戒时期间，如果不小心打破了戒时，是不是这四月苦行戒时就完全被打破了？该如何补救呢？ Obeisance to Guru Maharaj. In the Chaturmasya, if I'm not careful to break the vow, that means all the fasting are break by this not careful. How should it be remedied?
Well, you have to observe the Bhishma Panchak at the end of the Chaturmasya.
你如果想补救的话，可以在Bhishma Panchak 这那个期间做一些苦行。
You can do the Bhishma Panchak at the end of the Chaturmasya. That will make up for any deviations in the course of the 4 months.
你可以在Chaturmasya的最后的 Bhishma Panchak 期间做这个苦行，这样就可以补救你在这四个月期间所有的偏离。
Bhishma Panchak is the last 5 days of Chaturmasya.
Bhishma Panchaka is Chaturmasya's last 5 days.
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Mei Ling. Hare Krishna Gurudev, 顶拜您莲花祖。 一个人对Krishna之觉的爱和信心多少，是不是由个人的业报所决定？ 如果一个人的业报比较重，他就很容易受外在事物的影响，无法专注于Krishna之觉， 这样就对Krishna没有爱和信心。 这还是在业报轮回中，如何能跳出这种业报的影响呢？ 念诵不专注，是不是也是因为没有信心和爱？ 那又如何通过念诵得到Krishna仁慈呢？ 比如说Madhaji是奉献者，丈夫不是奉献者， Madhaji不仅有自己的业报， 还要承担丈夫吃肉杀生的 罪恶行为，这样的灵性进步是否更加艰难？ Hare Krishna, good day. Obeisance to your lotus feet. Whether a person love Krishna conscious, 一个人对 Krishna 知觉的，对 Krishna 的爱和信心多少，是不是？ The faith and the love for Krishna, is that depend on his karma?
No.
一个人对Krishna的爱和信心不是由他的业报所决定的。
No, it doesn't depend on karma.
Because she said, if one's karma is very heavy, then he is very easy to disturb by the other things, cannot focus on Krishna consciousness, then he cannot have the love and faith in Krishna consciousness.
Well, it doesn't necessarily mean like that. One's karma, maybe the bad karma can bring people to Krishna consciousness sometimes. People, they're suffering so much. That's why people sometimes come to Krishna.
就是说一个人的业报如果很重的话，并不意味着他会影响他的窥视那知觉，反而有的时候这样的业报能够把一个人带到窥视那知觉。我们有时候看到一个人他遭受很大的痛苦，反而来到了窥视那知觉。
So they have to have done some agyata sukriti. They have to have some sukriti. Means they have to have done some service for a devotee. They have to have done something which qualifies them to get devotion.
他们得做一些 agyata sukriti， 意味着他们得做一些奉献服务，得做一些对奉献者的服务，对 Krishna 的服务，这样他们才能够有资格获得奉献服务。
If somehow they did service for a devotee, then that can help them to come to bhakti yoga.
由于某种情况下，他如果能够做一些对奉献者的服务的话，这样他就能够来到奉爱瑜伽之中。
So that means you do service for a devotee means you do something like you donate money or.You help a devotee, and when the devotee is sick, or maybe you take care of him, or you do something for to help him.
比如说，你做一些对奉做一些服务给予奉献者，比如说，你可以做一些布施，或者在他们生病的时候照顾他们，或者他们有需要的时候你帮助了他们，这些都是对奉献者的一些服务。
So you serve the devotee that opens the doors to liberation. It's very powerful.
服务奉献者可以为你打开解脱之门，这是非常有力量的。
So you have to have done something like you have to have done some of these pious activities in relation to a devotee. You helped. Maybe you distributed books.
你得做一些这样的虔诚活动，这样能够帮助你和奉献者的这种关系。比如说，你还可以派一些书。
Yeah, you did some service for the temple or for the devotees.
你做一些给予庙宇的服务，帮助奉献者的服务。
Then that qualifies you for.That can help you to come to Bhakti Yoga.
这样能够帮助你来到奉爱瑜伽。
Krishna describes four reasons why people come to devotional service, and one of them is in distress.
Krishna 描述了四类虔诚的人来到 Krishna 知觉，其中第一个就是非常痛苦的人。
So you said people in distress, their karma is so bad they can't come, but Krishna says.People in distress can come if they're pious, but they have to be pious. They have to have some sukriti.
你说到由于一些人受他业报的影响，有可能来不到 Krishna 知觉。但是 Krishna 描述了，如果有四类人，其中一类人就是很痛苦的人，受业报很痛苦的人，他们来到了 Krishna 知觉。但是他们来到 Krishna 知觉的前提是他们得做一些 agyata sukriti。得做一些这样的虔诚活动。
They've had some contact with devotees.
他们得和奉献者有一些关系和联系。
And they did some service for them.
或者他们做一些服务给予奉献者。
So that qualifies them for devotional service.
这样让他们就变得有资格从事奉献服务。
But some people are very attached to sense gratification. You know, they can't give up sense gratification. So they're attached to their sinful activities. They don't want to become devotees.
如果有一些人，他们非常专注于他们的感官享乐，非常专注于、非常依附于他们的这些罪恶活动的话，他们就无法来到 Krishna 知觉了。If the chanting are not very focused, that means he didn't have faith and love.
Well, The chanting is not very focused. They have to practice more. They have to do more chanting.
念诵不专注，意味着他得做更多的练习，更多的念诵。
You have to have the desire to want to chant good. You have to really want to do good chanting.
而且你得在念诵的时候有这种愿望，想要好好的念诵，有这种好的japa，好的念诵。
If you're not very serious in the chanting, then you won't get the good result.
如果你念诵的时候并没有很认真地对待这个念诵的话，你也不会得到好的结果的。If chanting are not focused, how can through the chanting get the Krishna's mercy?
Well, you have to focus the chanting. You want to get Krishna's mercy, you have to work on the chanting, you have to focus.
如果你想得到 Krishna 的仁慈，那你就得在念诵的时候专心。
You have to want something badly. If you don't care about it, then you won't get it.
你想要这个事情，但是如果你不在乎它，你也不会得到它。If the Mataji is devotee, the husband are not devote, is not devotees. Mataji have her own karma, and she should also share his her husband karma and sinful actions. So.This advancement for the Matajis, it means very more difficult than before.
Yes, that's right.
是的，他是要他的进步是会更加的艰难。
Because she's got married, she picked a husband, she chose a husband, she decided to take this man for the husband.This was her karma.
因为是这个 Mataji 自己选择的这个丈夫，那她就得承担这个业报。
So there's some karma there, yeah. You can't avoid that.
这个里面确实是有业报的，你无法避免它。
But still, if she's very serious, then she can progress.
但是仍然，如果这个 Mataji， 如果这个 Mataji 非常的认真的话，他依然能够获得进步。
The husband and the wife they get old, and when they start to get old, then they're not so intimate, they're not so affectionate.
当丈夫和妻子都变得非常非常老，都变得开始老的时候，他们二者之间影响就没有那么大了。
We say from the age of 50, then you're supposed to retire. You're supposed to do austerity.
比如说在50岁的时候，二者都应该想要退休，都应该退休，进入开始弃绝。
So family life is, that's for 25 to 50, but then after 50, then you have to become more serious.
25岁到50岁是属于家庭生活，到了50岁之后又就应该变得更加的严肃认真起来。
We have to get ready for the next life.
他应该要准备为下一生做准备了。Next question from Zhang Yun Chang. Obeisance to Guru and all devotees, I want to ask, what is the material of the spiritual planet?
The material of the spiritual planet is pure spirit, Brahman.
灵性世界的材质是纯灵性的 Brahman.
And it's eternal, full of bliss and knowledge.
而且充满着极乐和知识。
Lord Krishna's body and the body of all the living entities in the spiritual world are all Satchit Ananda.
主 Krishna 的躯体以及灵性世界所有生物体的躯体，他们都是 Satchit Ananda， 永恒知识和极乐。Next question from 徐小元。Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Guru 和翻译，在灵性世界之中，地球上的六个月等于月球上的一天，在物质世界里，月球围绕着地球转，这样的话意味着月球上很多天才相当于地球上的，月球上的很多天才相当于地球上的一天。我的问题是，灵性世界和物质世界的时间计算方式不是一样的，是吗？Hare Krishna, obeisance to Guru. In the spiritual world, in the earth, the 6 months equal to 1 day in the moon god, in the moon planet. So, but in the material world, the moon planet move around to the earth. So that means many days in the earth, in many days in the moon are equal to the 1 day in the earth. So my question is, in the spiritual world and in the material world, these two worlds, the calculation of the time is different, is that right?
You have to understand there's no time in the spiritual world.
你得要理解在灵性世界是没有时间的。
The spiritual world is, in the spiritual world, there's no need of a sun or a moon.
在灵性世界没有必要有太阳和月亮。
So the moon goes around the earth, one time around the earth, that's 1 month.
所以月球围绕着地球转绕一圈是一个月。
Right? We heard there's a bright fortnight and a dark fortnight. The moon is dark for two, it's getting darker and then it gets brighter. For it takes 1 month.The movements of the moon.
我们在这一章听到了有这个月缺的两个星期，还有这个月满的两个星期。
So time, the time on this planet is different from time in the higher planets. The time in the higher planets, like one year here is like one day there.
这里的时间和一些高等星宿的时间是不同的，这里的一年相当于高等星宿的一天。
And then the planet of Brahma, one day of Brahma is thousands and millions of years.
而主 Brahma 的一天是千百万年。
One day of Brahma, there's 1,000 ages. One age means the four the Satya Yuga, Treta Yuga, Dwapara Yuga, Kali Yuga. They make up, and there's one, that's one age, and there's 1,000 ages in one day of Brahma. And that one day of Brahma, that's just only 12 hours, it's just like,Not 24 hours, that's just 12 hours.
主 Brahma 一天是一千个年代之和，而一个年代就相当于四个这个金银铜铁这四个年代，所以主 Brahma 的一天是四个年代的一千 四个小年代加在一起的一千个年代。
So Kali Yuga is 432,000 years.
卡利年代是432万年。
So one age is 10 times that, means 4,320,000 years.
所以十个年十倍的就是432万年。
And multiply by 1,000 because 1,000 ages and one day of Brahma.
而一千个这个年代就要再得乘上一千，就相当于主 Brahma 的一天。
So that's one day of Brahma. Just imagine.Brahma is at the top of the universe.
所以这只是主 Brahma 的一天，而主 Brahma 是整个宇宙的最顶端。
The sun god, the moon god, they're different. They're lower down in the universe.
太阳神和月神他们都比主 Brahma 要稍微低一些，要低一些。
But they're also heavenly planets.
他们也属于天堂星球。
Okay.
Okay. Good day. I think have two questions.
Okay.
Shall we continue?
Yeah, last two questions, no more.
Okay, yes. Next question from Bhakti, 顶拜 Guru, 顶拜所有的奉献者，请问 Guru, 多纳老师和高尚的婆罗门为什么走多帕塔为什么夺走多帕塔一半的王国，后来教授多帕塔的儿子军事居住，后者展示了婆罗门的慷慨胸怀，前者又报仇。我怎样评价他呢？ Hare Krishna, basis to Guru, I want to ask, the Dona Acharya is a very qualified Brahmana, why he want to get the Dwapata's half kingdom, and then he teaches Dwapata's son Dishtadyumna all the techniques. It shows the generous of the Brahmana, but it also shows the Dronacharya's his revenge. So how can do the full judgment to the Dona Acharya. evaluate, how do we evaluate Dona Acharya?
Well, you have to understand that he had a son and he wanted to take care of his son, but he could not even provide milk for his son.
你要了解的是 Dona Acharya 他有一个儿子，他甚至不能给他的儿子提供一杯牛奶。
And his son's friends, they made a fool of him. They gave him a glass of water with chalk in it, and they told him this is milk, and he drank it, and he thought it was milk.
他儿子的这些同学给他的儿子，就是给他做了一个恶作剧。他把这一个水里面倒上一个白色的粉末，就说这个里面就是牛奶。所以让他的儿子喝了下去，给他儿子恶作剧了一下。
So Dronacharya felt very bad that he had no money to take care of his son. So he came and he had to he'd been insulted by Draupada. Draupada insulted him. Draupada had been at school with him in the Gurukula, they had been friends. And Draupada promised that, you know, we're friends, that we will always help each other.
所以多纳查尔就为此感觉到非常的难受，于是他就去找多帕达，因为多帕达曾经在古鲁库拉的时候和他是同学，他就去找多帕达。
So when Drona had no money, he came to Draupada and he asked Draupada to help him. But Draupada said no. He said, I can't be a friend of you. He said, friendship is only possible between equals.He said, you have no, you're not equal to me. You have nothing. And I have a kingdom. So we cannot be equals. We cannot be friends.
所以，当多纳查尔想去找多帕达去要一些钱的时候，多帕达说：“我们不可能是朋友，朋友都建立在平等的基础上。你是一个很贫穷的人，我们怎么可能是朋友呢？”
And so then he arranged. He trained all of the children, the sons of the Kurus and the Pandavas, and then he sent them to defeat Draupada. And then they brought Draupada as a prisoner, and they put him at the feet of Drona.
于是多纳查尔就训练了所有的库鲁的这些孩子们，训练他们，然后让他们把多帕达给抓了，就是在这场战争之中把多帕达给抓了起来，关到了监狱里。
So then Drona took half the kingdom and sent Draupada away.
所以多纳查尔就从多帕达那里拿走了半个王国。
And so then Draupada did his sacrifice to get revenge, and he got the son who would kill Drona.
这样，这个多纳查尔就报了仇。
He got a son who would kill Drona.
Okay, 多帕达然后就想得到一个儿子，得到了一个儿子，想报这个仇，想杀掉多纳查尔。
So then Drona took that boy, Dhrishtadyumna, he took him as a student.
然后多纳查尔就后来又接受了 Dhrishtadyumna, 也就是多帕达的儿子，接受他为自己的学生。
Yeah, he knew this boy is going to kill me.
他知道这个孩子将来就会杀掉我。
But he thought, I'm a Brahmana, I should teach him.
但是他觉得自己是一个婆罗门，他应该教授他。
Okay, what's the last question?
The last question is from Zhen Zhen Hare Krishna. 亲爱的 Guru Maharaj, 顶拜您甜美脸，顶拜翻译和主持人风云。如果我接受了别人为了帮助我花的钱，我是不是也要承担别人的业报？ If I accept the money that the others want to help me, that means I should also share others' karma.
Yeah.
是的。
Yeah, you take money from people, you also get karma with it.
如果你从别人那里得到一些钱的话，你确实是要从别人那里
承担一些业务。Prabhupada told devotees, they must be very careful. When they go out to sell books, and people give them money, he said, you must be very careful. He said, you take money from sinful people, you'll get karma.
圣帕巴德告诉这些去派书的奉献者，如果你们出去派书找别人要钱的时候，你们得小心，因为你从别人那里拿的钱，你都是要接受别人的业报的。
So the Brahmanas in the past, they would not take any charity from people who were sinful.
过去的婆罗门不会从那些罪恶的人那里接受布施。
So you take money from people who are sinful, yeah, you get some karma. You must be careful to use all the money for Krishna's service.
你从这些罪恶的人那里接受这个布施，你就得非常小心，而且你得把这个钱，你花这个钱得非常小心，你得把这个钱用于对 Krishna 的服务之中才行。
Okay, we have to stop very late.
Okay, 我们今天得停止了。
Om Ganshir Sabuddha Rai Prabhu Gave Om Jantai Dufani Om Ganshir Soi Dufang Shiansa Tiwan Ling Ting Om Jufani Wanshit Rui Chuanjiao Shunli Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai
Jai
Go back to Vrinda Ki
Jai